I want to ask you another question. Do you see the color blue in this painting? This is the painting Athena appearing to Odysseus to reveal the island of Ithaca by Giuseppe Bottani. It's a depiction of a scene from Homer's Odyssey. Those stories, or rather one specific read of those stories, sparked a tremendous controversy that an increasingly colorful world only made worse. Does everyone see the same colors if they don't have names for them? Or read that differently. What do you call the colors between the ones you know the names of? And what does that say about you and your culture and about how the brain works? Because color is a really good way to understand linguistics, which makes it a really good way to try to understand cognition. In 1858, 10 years before this guy became Prime Minister of England, he wrote a book called Studies on Homer and the Homeric Age. He pointed out that Homer never used a word that meant blue or green in the original. Sure, the sea might be wine dark and dawn might be rosy fingered, but like, what does that even mean? Gladstone had a hypothesis. The ancient Greeks, he said, didn't see color like we do. They didn't say blue because they couldn't see blue. That's nonsense, of course. They were humans, they had human eyeballs and brains, they didn't lack the blue photoreceptor or have different eyes that function differently than ours. And, you know, maybe the ocean wasn't blue, maybe it was green or black. But most translators today agree that the Greeks were using color words just differently. Those were colors that meant something to them, that had what scientists call salience. You remember those color orders that I showed you? Plato's version of that went from white to black. And one of the primaries that he used was translated roughly to like sparkling or brilliant. That was a specular illumination. That specular look was something that they valued. So that may be what the wine dark sea was all about.